everybody. How's it going today? Hope you're all having a great day wherever you are, wherever in the world. Today we're doing something a little different. We're going to a place that you don't normally see me at, because I don't normally go here. So recently I've been learning a lot about climate change and how it's affecting the world, and specifically the world's oceans. So today we're here at the beach checking out the ocean, because I wanted to talk to you guys about how climate change has been affecting our world's oceans. So a couple of main ways that it's been doing that is through, you know, global temperatures are rising, making ocean waters rise in temperature, making them a lot warmer in certain areas. Another thing that's happening is because of CO2 emissions from us, ocean acidification has been a problem in certain areas. So one of the problems that we've had in Southwest Florida with our oceans has been red tide. If you don't know what red tide is, it's a higher than normal concentration of algae out in the Gulf of Mexico. It's caused by Karenia brevis, and this is a naturally occurring algae out in the Gulf, but when it gets in high concentration, it can become toxic. Now, this is toxic to marine life, birds, fish, even manatees can be killed by it, and it's an irritation, a lung irritation to humans, so they often close down beaches whenever the blooms are present. So the way this stuff forms is higher water temperatures helps foster growth. We have nutrient runoff coming out of the Okeechobee that helps it grow. And then when some pretty severe storm systems blow through, it tends to kind of gather all that stuff up, put it in one place, and then it just makes it bloom explosively. And that's what we saw happen in 2018 because of Hurricane Irma the year before. So another area of the world where climate change is affecting the oceans is over off Australia's coast, and I'm talking about the Great Barrier Reef. The reef has been rapidly diminishing over the past few years because of warmer ocean temperatures, ocean acidification, and intense storms blowing through. The warmer temperatures are stressing and bleaching the coral reefs, which eventually leads to decaying and even dead coral. In the video shown, each time lapse represents 2 months of bleaching and decay. Over the past 200 years, Earth's oceans have absorbed about 30% of the extra carbon dioxide that humans have injected into the atmosphere. This is where the term ocean acidification came from, as it has lowered the pH levels in oceans, making them more acidic. This degrades the coral skeletons, causing reef structures to break down. Thus, it is easier for intense storms to destroy the reef, as they are in a weakened state from the acidification and bleaching. This isn't something confined to the coast of Australia. It is happening all over the world, even though we don't see it every day. Since 2016, about half of the Great Barrier Reef has died, showing the world how much of a problem climate change can be.
A lot of people don't see climate change as a big issue because it's not immediately affecting them. This type of mentality is a problem because it'll let it get out of hand before it's too late to fix anything. We need to raise awareness about climate change, and that's why I'm sharing this video with you guys today. I hope you all learn something new, and I encourage you to go out and look up, learn more about climate change, to see what you can do to help the environment, even if it is just a little bit. Thanks for watching the video today, guys. Hope to see you in the next one.